One recurring feature in a lot of complicated circuits is you're rarely running low on microcontroller pins. So there's a bunch of functionality, and I need dedicated pins on the microcontroller to do each of them. A lot of sins are committed in circuits in order to save a few microcontroller pins. Let me show you an example. Here I've got a circuit with two LEDs, a red and a green, and two wires connecting to two logic pins. So pin 3 is connected to red. Pin 3 high, the red LED turns on. Pin 2 is 1, and pin 3 is 0. Then I can light the other LED. We're using the fact that LEDs are diodes. Driving the circuit this way, then the ground doesn't face the right direction, so no current flows through this LED. Whereas if I swap it around with the voltage the other way, then the current flows the opposite direction, and then the other LED lights up. I can actually switch back and forth between lighting either of these LEDs by switching the polarity from one to the other. The problem is, I can only turn one of them on at a time. So one pin has to be high, the other pin has to be low, and I can't make them both come on at once with this wiring. But there's a surprising trick to avoid that, so watch what happens as I speed up. It's kind of an annoying flashing, to be honest. If I went for 10 milliseconds, it looks like they're both on at once in the camera. In person, I can see maybe a little bit of flickering. If we drop the delay down to 1 millisecond, so the surprising thing is that these LEDs are not on at the same time, but they really look like they're on at the same time because they're flickering back and forth so fast. LEDs have no problem blinking on and off in 1 millisecond. That's actually a pretty long time for them. And human vision takes a long time to respond. The human eyeball can actually pick up patterns that fast. As long as it's moving rapidly, it'll leave a trail in your vision, especially in the dark. So this is what this looks like. We have two wires, and we have two LEDs, so being able to turn two LEDs on with two wires doesn't seem like that big a trick. Here we've upgraded the circuit to support four LEDs, and we're only using three pins to do this, which I still have control over each of these, except the only way that I can have any two of a pair on at the same time is with this trick of switching back and forth really quickly. The red pin is common to all the LEDs. I can add more LEDs between the green and the white pins, and then I could get a total of six LEDs off of only three pins. N jumper wires can support n times n minus 1, almost n squared LEDs. You see this trick all over, like in 7-segment displays. You might scan through, hitting the common ground of each digit, and then sharing all of the drive pins for each of those. This provides the illusion that all of the digits are on at once, but you only use the pins to keep one at a time. It looks smooth and solid.